It would appear as though we are going live here. Welcome to IVRL Playoffs Vail Group Stage. First match of the day, live on IVRL2. I'm Zuck. That's Rips.
I'm Rips.
We're going live here. We've got leftovers against Limrue.
Limerick.
We're live here on Pistol Round. Looks like Limerick, Limrue, I'm not quite sure, is working their way over to the A-bomb site here. Setting up with all five in the museum area right now. Looks like Leftover is setting up with a pretty standard defense here.
Absolutely, yeah. Just going to sit and they're going to wait. Getting a little spooly there, it looks like. Ultimate standoff going on.
Not committing to the bomb site just yet. They're trying to set up, maybe trying to work a pick, look for a little bit of aggression out of leftovers, field them out. Ryan going to bust his way out middle, but Vreezer going to take him down from bridge there. That was a good pickup. Oh, and Hector also going to push into A main there and picked up on Sleepy there. That leaves only three members of Limerick. I'm sorry.
You're good,
buddy. I wish I knew. Sylvath trying to get out there, but Hector going to be holding that down. Cash going to try and get the refrag on him. Not able to hit shots there.
So 5-2 all still.
All the members of Leftovers now closing in on these last two remaining members. Hip's going to get taken down by Hector. Big round by Hector there. He picks up 3 on that pistol round. Very nice. And I'm hoping that I'm setting the score for the correct team. We got everything working correctly, ladies and gentlemen. We're good out here.
If we don't, we won't know.
We're going to bust our way into round number 2 here. Let's see what the attackers are going to do here. Looks like they're going to set up for a heavy B here. All 5 members committing towards bottom of skate park here. Looks like leftovers.
Oh, push, they're going to play for picks again. That'll be the.
We'll have to see. It looks like they're getting involved right away. Leftovers, pretty standard setup. They got one on B, one in the grass arch area, one guy playing mid, and they've got 2 playing A. Pretty normal setup. Looks like Limerick heading their way into middle, into the club, trying to bust out kegs here. 4 coming up kegs. Vreezer going to take down 1. Sylvath going to try to get the refrag. He's going to trade out, but that's going to leave it in a 4-on-3 situation in favor of Leftovers here. 3 more members.
Yeah, they need at least 1 more pick.
Absolutely. They've got mid control now. Hector's going to try and get involved. He's going to catch Sleepy in the back. He's looking the wrong way. That's unlucky right there for sure.
Unlucky.
Cash going to get, or sorry, Hip's going to get taken down by Hector as well.
Cash, last one left.
Cash, big job ahead of him. 1v4 situation. Sitting in Kev's here. He's got a lot of time left on the clock. 45 seconds. Can go anywhere. Have you seen the bomb go down? Looks like the bomb is down on the bridge. Pixel Toter, Vendetta, Shamrush, they've all really got excellent control on this. Cash is going to probably choose the wise option here. Try to come around from the skate park side. Running out of time. 30 seconds left on the clock. He's got to get the bomb, kill 4, and plant. This is a monumental task here for him. Vendetta's going to peek out from alley and take him out. That's going to be another round in favor of Leftovers. Good start here by Leftovers.
Good try. Still anybody's game.
Round starting. Anybody's game, that is right. I gotta alt tab back into my game here. All right.
They're heading towards the museum.
Yeah, it looks like they're gonna.
Nope, didn't go mid.
Looks like their style is heavily favoring just 5-man pushes out of one area.
Looks like they're still playing slow, still playing picks, it looks like, unless, Volbooms in with the enemy team. They could come in right behind him. They could send somebody through mid. Boom.
Yeah, they don't really have enough map control here to watch their flanks, but it looks like they're going to try to get some utility out. Going to get a smoke out, help them execute, cut down some of those lines of sight. Here it comes. 3 going into long A, 2 going into A main. Oh, I'm in the. All right, let's get back here. Couple of big frags there from Leftovers. Cash able to pick up Vreezer there. Looks like it's a 2-on-3 now.
Yep.
Cash, another good pick, but he's 1-on-2 now.
Oh.
That's another round in favor of Leftovers.
Yeah.
What do you think? What do you think Limerick needs to do here to get on the board, Rips?
I need a full send. Full send, 5-man push, or 4-man push, 1 mid, bad pie send him. That's what I would do.
Yeah, I think that they're lacking a little bit of the map control that we'd normally see teams try to use on this map.
Yeah.
And they're really...
pick a little bit long, yeah.
Looks like they're going to go back for the A bomb site. They did have a pretty good success. This is a much faster execute. They're getting smokes out really quickly here. Big nade in from Hector. Another nade coming in. Oh, that was a flashbang. Sylvath going to be fighting Hector here. Nice refrag. Picking him up. That's going to come to a 4-on-4 situation.
4-4, yeah.
This is a really clean-looking execute here. They've got a lot of map control. Vreezer's going to get involved from bridge. He's going to take him down. Pixel's going to peek from the backside. He's going to take down Ryan. 2-on-4. Cash, good pickup on to Shamresh there. Oh, a huge nade and a good pick by Vendetta.
And that's what they call utility. Utilized correctly. That was a good throw.
Leftovers looking really, really strong and authoritative during these early rounds here. Coming out early with a 4-0 win. Clearly they've been putting the time in on Keedy. Looking very, very good right now.
Absolutely, yeah, yeah. There looks like a lot of practice paying off right now.
Absolutely.
Ooh, some different here.
Well, looks like they're going for a 5-person mid push.
I like it. I like where this is going.
This is bold. We know Rips loves mid. Let's see what happens here. They're going to come up to Vreezer. Vreezer's sitting in top of three-way here. Getting a nade in. Ryan has to watch out here. This could be big. Vreezer with a big pickup. Smoke coming out. That's going to allow Limerick to get out now.
Yep, they full send right now.
A lot of coughing in that smoke. Got to be careful about your health, your lungs. Vreezer's going to take down Ryan as he tries to come out into the tarps area, skate park there. Sleepy's going to get the refrag on him, but the damage is already done. Vreezer was able to take down two, and that leaves him in a 4-on-3 situation in favor of Leftovers. Lots of time left on the clock here, though. Anything can happen. Hip's going to be trying to work his way over to A, but Hector, just huge plays. Shamrock's going to be peeking on the bridge. Big refrag. Yeah, that was a trade. Cash trying to work on Hector here, but Hector just shutting it down. Coming out strong early with a 9-1, 8-3. Hector and Vreezer really putting on a clinic right now.
Round starting.
Absolutely.
All right.
Heading over to the skate park. Going to do a kickflip.
Round number 6. Yep. Another 5-person push out of skate park here. See what they can do.
Just kill the one in mid.
Freezer's going to be waiting. He's going to be
right in there.
Oh, I'm not sure if Freezer saw that. Sleepy's going to try and get the pick there, but Freezer's going to smartly pull away from that fight. Good pick. Good entry from Sylvath onto the B player, Vendetta. Oh, and Freezer getting picked up by Hips in club there. 5-on-3.
Nice. This is Ryan. This is their comeback. They're on the board.
Pushing up through alley here. But face off against two members. He's going to get taken down by Pixel. Can Sleepy and Sylvath get the refrag? Hips also working his way up. But Hector's on the flank right now. And alley going to be working on Hips.
Ooh.
Oh, and what looked like a really good push is now crumbled. And it's all up to Sleepy. Takes down Pixel. One-on-one situation. Hector's going to be working his way back up. He knows that he's around grass. His teammate has to have called that. Sleepy's got all the time left on the clock. He's going to pick up the bomb. Working their way over to CTP. I think he may have detected that Hector's in the B bomb site now. He's going to come out, gun up, and he peeks. Incredible play there. What a 1v1 by Sleepy there.
Absolutely. They're on the board. Here
big 1v2. Let's see if the instant replay button works. I don't know if it does. It works.
Ready.
No, it's a clip from Suna. That is definitely not working. We'll fix that. All right. Back in action here. Round number 7. Looks like Limerick's going to go for a split play here. 2 towards A, 3 towards B.
Looks like they're playing for picks again.
Yeah, really slow play. Watching for the aggression coming out of Leftovers here.
Yeah, and Breezer holding down mid still. Throwing a little bit of util.
Ooh, Big trade there. Hector and Cash taking each other down in the museum A main area.
They might fit now. They didn't fall forward though.
Limericks has a lot of skate park control right now. They're up in the cave. Vendetta's going to pick up that early frag though, and Shamrush and Hip's going to trade themselves out. That leaves it in a 2-on-3 situation. Silvath looking for that B player. He knows he's there. Coming around the corner here. He's got the advantage on the peak, and it ends up being a trade. And it's 1-on-2. It's Sleepy again in a 1-on-2 situation. They've proven themselves capable of these situations. You think they can do it now?
Absolutely. We'll see if Sleepy can take the Breezer on.
Wow, he looked checked the left. Should have checked the right. That was really close. Yeah. And that's going to be another round in favor of Leftovers.
Yeah, do you have the...
Round starting.
Pardon?
Let's not worry about it.
Roger that. All right. Back in the action here. Round number 8. Looks like Limerick's opting to do a split setup again and the exact opposite. Instead of 2 at A, they've got 3 at A. Oh, no. Looks like they're actually going to go for some mid-pressure here. Maybe they're really splitting up this round. Let's see if it works out. Silvath going to be working their way into the A area here, trying to come up into long A. Big pick on the backside player. Nice shot there from Silvath. Hector coming around back on, though. Oh, and he gets him in the back there. That's unfortunate.
Yep, he should have been looking that way.
Although, meantime, Ryan and Sleepy have moved their way up to B. They're in the site right now. They have full site control, but Vendetta smartly waiting it out on the arches. Hips and Crash coming up now into alley. Vries are going to take down Hips. Cash going to get the refrag and pick up the double onto Shamrush.
And now a 2-1.
Excellent play there. All up to Hector. Cash going to be putting a little bit of pre-fire down and picks up the trade.
Nice trade out. Yep. That is 6-2.
Yeah, I really think the difference maker there was they actually split up and were working together. When the player was coming out A, when the player was coming out of A, they were already up on B, and I think that threw Leftovers for a loop. Let's see if they do that again.
Absolutely. You love to see it.
Love to see it. Looks like they are going to try and split up a little bit again. See if Leftovers makes any adjustments. What appears that they're playing it same, but Freezer pushing into kegs here. Very aggressive into the kegs. See if we can ride along. Riding along now with Freezer. It's going to be coming up against Cash and Hips. Ooh. Looks like Hector going to pick up Silvath. Cash is right here. Right around the corner. Cash going to be coming out slow. Freezer picks him up. Doesn't spot the other player though. Falling back now.
He picked up the second kegs.
Huge play from Freezer. There's a third coming through. Getting some utility out. Throws the nade. There's two there. Oh, that's a perfect nade. He takes him down.
That's a 3K. almost with the 4. Good play by Freezer.
I'm really hoping my instant replay worked this time. Nope. Still Suna. That's too bad.
Well, you know what they say. Yeah, rather sooner than later.
One on four, Sleepy, last person remaining for Limerux. I'm really not sure.
Limerick. I don't know. That's the pronunciation
I'm so sorry for all of you on that team that are listening now and we're butchering your team's name. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, but I apologize profusely. Well, you just say one, I'll say the other, so we're half long, half right, you know, that kind of situation.
And Pixel's going to pick up Sleepy there. 7-2, a pretty commanding lead, but they have one more round on attack here. They really need to pick it up. Going in to defense, 7-3 on this map is not a bad place to be.
Yeah, absolutely.
Looks like they are going to opt for a little bit of a split attack here once again. That seems to be working well for them. They had some success compared to the earlier 5-man pushes that they were doing.
Absolutely, yeah. I think they were a little bit slow on those, and they would miss the pick, and then the whole thing would collapse. I think now with the split, this might be the way to go.
Absolutely, yeah. Silvath, a couple of good smokes on a B bomb site here. Going to be working up. Going to have to fight Vendetta hiding in the corner there on the right. Meanwhile, the rest of the team seems to be waiting. Silvath, unfortunate, backs into the gun of Freezer, who's got mid control here. That's an unfortunate pick. I it appeared as though maybe they were trying to fake B there for a later A execute. Just got a little bit caught up and overcommitted. Ryan gonna be coming up though. Hector is really close here, right around the corner.
Vector or
Island
go mid. Ooh.
Hector picks that one up. I think Hector knows there's more here.
Yeah, but Cash.
Freezer's rotating over. Yeah, Freezer's giving up mid, and Cash is coming up kegs now. Nade's coming in. Boom, boom, everywhere. Pixel pushing up on long A. Hips, last one here at A main. Cash has alley control. Has to flank around. This is a huge task now. Hips coughing away in the smoke. They're going to run by. He's going to pick up one. Freezer right on top of him. Oh, he picks him up. And it's all down to Cash in a 1-on-4 situation. Not much time left on the clock. Really needs to move it. Get the Nikes on here. Get out there. Get in there. Similar to swimwear. Let's go.
Full Adidas.
Absolutely. Cash trying to peek it out. Trying to pick up one here. Shamresh, though, is going to respond with the Vector. Take him down.
Really good shooting.
And that's going to be an 8-2 half in favor of Leftovers. I guess one of the logos is the IVRL Pro League Veil. That's fine. We're okay with that.
Leftovers, they are at 8. I'm assuming that LR stands for Limerick or Limerick, whatever one it is.
I hope so, because that's the way we have it set up currently. Looks like a pretty standard setup. Well, actually, no. A heavy A setup from defense here on Limerick's. Leftovers, really slow pistol round here. Three players working up museum, two players working up middle. This is interesting. I haven't seen much of this.
Absolutely. What is...
They're shuffling their way in there, trying to make not very much noise at all.
Absolutely, yeah.
Freezer and Vendetta.
Quiet shoes on.
Ryan, though, is flanking through club here. Ryan picks up one. Freezer going to refrag. Silvac knows he needs to get in there. Beats him down. Took him out.
That's a mid control right there.
That was really good mid control. Yeah, and now the...
And three that's the execute. They're pushing out of museum. Cash picking up one.
Two members left. 2-on-4. Pixel not able to get the rear shot on Cash. Spins around. Shamrash, last one. Ooh. Takes down one. Sleepy. Gonna refrag. Big round there on defense. That's what they needed. Absolutely. Down 8-2. Gonna bring that a little bit closer with 8-3. Making this one a game. That's one for more. Sure.
Round starting.
All right. Back in the action now.
Yeah, absolutely. Defense still splitting. I'll do another 3-2 split. Is that mid or is that?
They've got three going towards B, skate park, and two going towards mid right now, leftover setting up.
Absolutely. That was a frag grenade for a second. That would have been huge.
There's a huge pick from Silvath there into the lower skate park player, but Freezer's going to push up Alley, take a little bit of control there, and take down Ryan with him. Going to have to battle Cash now. At the end of Alley, Cash knows he's there. Hips rotating over to support. Big trade coming out of Cash and Freezer there. Sleepy, though. Sleepy. Big pick on Hector flanking around. It's all left of these last two members of Leftovers.
Last one, 1v2.
Going to go one for one there with the trades. 1-on-2 situation. Looks like Pixel does...
He could... It's his ballpark.
Does have the bomb. Let's ride along now and see what's going on. 1 minute left on the clock. Clearing out B. A lot of work left to do here.
Oh, it's wide open. Whole map.
Yeah, both players of Limericks are in kegs, it appears. Yeah, they've pushed up and taken club control. Maybe they think the bomb is down there. I'm not quite sure.
I'm not sure either.
They've got bunker control now.
Old move.
And there's the plant. Now they know. They got to move together. Bottom line is they're both together. It's a 2-on-1. Pixel's going to have to kill both of them. If they stick together, they can get the refrag. They're splitting up a little bit now. Pixel's going to be waiting. Back bomb site has to hear them now. Knows they're coming. A little bit of gunfire. Throws a grenade. Nobody killed by that. Pixel just playing time here.
Absolutely.
Hips coming around the corner. Ooh, and a big trade.
It's open. Sleepy. Diffusing. Unscanning. Interrupting, that's what it is.
Scan interrupted.
Very good interrupt there. And that's another round. Defense in favor of Limerick's. They've They've really shown that they're a defensive-minded team. They got a really good setup, and they're getting the entries. Leftovers not able to find any momentum on attack yet. All right, kicking it off now. Looks like a heavy A push possibly this time coming out of Leftovers.
Yeah, I mean,
We got Vreezer and Hector going into mid. Looks like Shamoresh also going into mid. Yeah. Vendetta and Pixel setting up for Museum.
Full send, Vreezer rushing in there. I like that. That's what I would do.
Absolutely. Vreezer with another one.
Picking up, crossing bridge, picking him up, going behind, crossing pond. Oh, that's...
It would appear as though Vreezer has limited to no fear currently.
Absolutely.
A website is clear.
All the time.
Leftovers going to www.a.com. Hips, the last one remaining on bridge, going to run into Shamoresh, and he's not going to have that. Nice. Leftovers picks up their first attack round, bringing the score to 9-4, firmly in control right now.
This could be the comeback.
What happened to Sleepy?
Round starting.
What's going on with Sleepy?
Don't know.
I think Sleepy is also very confused. I've never seen this one.
Yeah, this is new.
Where is Sleepy? Oh no, not like that, Sleepy.
Sleepy, yeah. And this was, they're on the comeback, down a man. They're doing a full skate park defense round. They're definitely shaken up by this. This is unfortunate.
That would rattle me. And what a horrible time for that to happen. Definitely. Hector going to be taking a little bit of alley control here. Cash and Hips are right there. Vreezer's coming through as well. Wow. What a mid-execute. All up to Sylvath now. 1-on-5. Has a mountain to climb here.
He does.
Picks up one, though. Never count them out.
Absolutely. You know, they say never count your eggs before they hatch.
Sylvath really taking their time. Doesn't have the time to be crouching around like this. Needs to get in there and takes the trade. Ooh. That's another round in favor of Leftovers. One round to go, and then they've got the first map. Remember, this is a single elimination playoff bracket. Best of three maps. So if they win this map and next map, that's it. They've won. They're moving on.
Yep.
Let's see what they do here. Trying to close it out. Looks like they're going to try and set up towards A with some mid control again. Seems to be working well for them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, Vreezer and Hector both very comfortable in mid.
They got their Nikes on. They're getting in there.
Absolutely. And there he goes again, pushing that bridge.
Ryan going to come out for the repeat, though. Big pick on the Vreezer. Has to fight Hector now. Hector reloading. Oh, and they trade. And we have another trade as well. Sleepy and Pixel taking each other down. That leaves it in a 2-on-3 situation. The last two remaining members of Leftovers. Chilling at A-Long, fighting Sylvath right now. Rest of the team doesn't seem to be responding to it. Cash.
But they could go in there, scan that.
Yep. They do have
bridge.
They do have the scanners. Cash looks like they're trying to rotate through CTA right now. Hips has bridge control. Moved around a little bit, crouched, so he's silent. Possibly hears the bomb plant right now, but Vendetta not going to allow him to flank like that.
Yeah, Cash is on scan.
It's all up to Cash here. This map is on Cash's shoulders. 1-on-2 situation. Bomb is planted. Has to get involved here. Throws a flash out. Let's ride along with Cash.
Gonna
spot Shamoresh backside, picks him up. 1-on-1, 25 seconds left. Feel like he has a pretty good idea of where he is. Not able to find him initially on this clear of the site.
I don't think he knows where he is.
Timed.
Oh, he's gonna know.
Clicking
now.
Down.
There it is. Nice.
Good. And that's gonna be a map win for Leftovers, 11-4.
Absolutely.
Really good game. I'm not sure what button I'm supposed to press now, Rips, in all honesty.
I'm not the buttons guy, so I could not tell you. But great performance by Vreezer, 23-10. Sheesh. That's what I would say. And then everybody across the whole board. And we're back to the armory.
Yeah, I believe that the way that this tournament works for the three maps is each server spun up
Yep, as it goes along, yep.
Yeah, so we'll probably see a server spun up on Mar now that we can join up on. Let's see. We're going to hit it with a quick intermission here, and we'll be back for map two.
In 2 seconds.
Don't go anywhere. We'll have more Veil coming up.
So many nice people in the Veil community too, man. Like, it's a great community. We're really attracting some awesome people. I mean, I'm doing the pugs every night. We're doing pickup games. I'm meeting all these new people. They love the game. They just want to play competitively. I mean, it's so nice.
Absolutely.
I've been waiting for another community like this to pop up again. You know what I mean? That's what I'm used to. That's what happened with Onward, and that's what's happening now.
Thank you. So XLab was founded by accident.
In the future, virtual reality will become the first class experience.
We saw VR and thought, wow, like this is so cool. And we felt like since it was so small at the time that we actually can make a difference in gaming's landscape.
XLab really started off us three founders. We all had this vision to bring music, technology, and gaming together in one medium.
First, we started off with Elizabeth creating Water Planet. So Water Planet VR was Elizabeth's first foray into virtual reality. And what it was essentially her art project that combined her EP that was releasing some music that she was making with this story-driven narrative VR experience. And from 2014 to 2016, that's what we were working on.
We became very focused on multiplayer systems that scale. And the idea is to make large immersive multiplayer worlds online that people can make good use of VR hardware and technology to coexist and be immersed together.
Albert, he was working on his music VR experience as well. And he's just the beast. He started, you know, gamifying a little bit, putting some guns into it. And, you know, I was playing, this was 2017. So that's when the first two VR shooters that I played, I got into. And yeah, I had some friends in those communities. I was like, hey, come check out what my brother's doing. They tried it. They were like, this is awesome. Like, you should keep going. Like, you really have something here.
So this drawing right here started the story of Vale. So here we have the Earth. It's where Rayabs live. And here we have the colonies, where colonists live.
Every single day we'd work our day jobs. 6-7 o'clock would come. We'd come home, sometimes shower, sometimes not, eat food, sometimes not, and then just go straight to the studio.
It was Albert, Elizabeth, Jonathan, and I were all in a bunker. It was basically in a parking garage, no windows, no nothing.
At the time we had a little storage room that we were renting out for a few $100 a month inside of the garage of the building we were living in. And we just set up some PCs there and just started getting to work. And really, it was just a passion project.
That's basically the mission, bringing people together in a way that was impossible before.
Yeah, it's crazy how it's like far it's like gone.
Oh, the good news is now since Albert works all day at programming and I play games, I whoop it in Vale. So we're not doing too bad. Good morning to the VR community. My name is Tropical, and I'm the CEO of Vale VR. This morning, I'm challenging the CEO of every other major VR shooter. Here at XLab, we do things differently. We actually play games.
On August 31st.
Get ready to play me. You bring your team, I'll bring mine. Let's stream this for the entire VR community, because at the end of the day, what we do here is entertain. Everybody that's watching this, share this with the other studios, share with the community, because it's time for CEOs to actually play their own game so that we can make VR better as a whole. For the next 30 days, I'll be training.
All right, and we're back, sort of. Had a little bit of a technical difficulty with the Map 2 servers that seems to be solved, according to what I've been told. So we're just politely waiting for the server to spin up before we can resume Map 2 action.
Absolutely.
How are you feeling about today's matchup so far, Rips?
Pretty good. Pretty tired, but I'm seeing a lot of good effort out there. Good plays. Freezer holding down mid. That was big. He was doing things that I would do, and I like that. So,
yeah, Freezer was definitely getting in there, very similar to Swimwear. We love that. We love that. It seemed like I've gotten confirmation. It's Lime Rux is the right way to say their team name.
I still think you're wrong, but I guess I'll trust.
It's their team name, so.
Information from, but I'll trust it.
Ultimately, they were able to claw their way back quite a bit. Later into the colonist half, they were looking pretty good there. Starting to split up, get a little bit more map control, work some fakes. Caught leftovers off guard, absolutely, I think.
Yeah.
But leftovers, yeah, a little bit more importance on timing and getting in there and making the play. But ultimately, leftovers able to shut down that first map 11-4. So we're just waiting on the server for Mar to come up.
Spooled up.
While we're out here, today's sponsor for the cast is Antlion Mod Mics. Be heard better. Instantly transform high quality headphones into the ultimate headset with the world's first studio quality attachment microphone. Wired or wireless, digital or analog Rips. Mod Mic is a microphone that attaches to any headphones for the ultimate custom headset. Trusted by gamers,
for the people,
podcasters, streamers. You use one, right, Rips?
It's right here, buddy.
And online personalities all around the world. Take your voice communication to the next level with a Mod Mic from Antlion Audio. It's all about your experience.
Absolutely. I agree with all of that.
Very grateful for all the sponsors for this whole event, this whole tournament. It's been a blast working with everyone.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, seriously.
Still waiting for the server, Rips. Why haven't you started it yet?
Still waiting. I'll just make a custom game lobby.
Everybody join up. It's on Rips, guys. definitely on Rips.
I literally almost clicked that button too. There are some more servers. I don't know if it is actually the, no, I don't think it's the comp ones though.
Yeah, it does look like right now the only match that is still going on the first map there is Royal Strive and Coconuts. Ultimately, we're still waiting for these servers to pop up. We're going to cut back to a quick intermission here while we wait for the servers to fire up, and we'll be back with you guys soon for some more Veil action.
As fast as possible.
It was only one defender. Oh, looks like he might be able to
all four.
Lego for days.
Reggie with the ace.
Yeah.
Yeah, so games that inspire me. I think that VR games that are immersive are the most inspiring and the most exciting, honestly.
The first game that I ever fell in love with where I was just like eating Doritos, chips, Subway, McDonald's every day and like not wanting to do anything but that was RuneScape.
I mean, it really all started off with Warcraft 2.
At some point, World of Warcraft became a thing. And then that one just took me, like that literally took my life for 4 years.
I feel most engaged by highly social, competitive, real-time multiplayer games where I share a world with other players.
I mean, it's not very popular, but Battlefield. I do like Battlefield.
And the Battlefield series. Battlefield as well.
Other than that, I've just always been playing Call of Duty.
Call of Duty series.
Warzone.
I love playing like Black Ops Zombies with my friends.
Halo.
I'm gonna say Halo.
Halo land parties.
I'm not a big fan of Siege. Sorry, any Siege players.
Rainbow Six Siege.
Rainbow Six Siege. I think I have over 1K on that one.
At the core, I do like some shooters. CSGO.
Counter-Strike.
I like Counter-Strike. I like Valorant.
Valorant lately.
Shooter-wise, I like Apex Legends.
Destiny. Over 3,000 hours in Destiny.
Big fan of some old school RPGs like Dead Space.
The Last of Us.
In recent years, been really obsessed with Elder Scrolls.
Morrowind, so a lot of RPG type stuff.
If multiplayer is gonna be Genshin.
And I played a lot of open world games.
I remember getting into Minecraft back before it actually had an official release.
Ultima Online was my OG.
Rocket League.
Mass Effect. But art style for inspiration for Veil, Death Stranding.
Just got into Death Stranding, director's cut.
I'm heavily inspired by every single Half-Life game. Those are all amazing games.
I really enjoy horror games, Condemned, Resident Evil, stuff like that.
Super Mario Bros. Old school.
Super Mario Bros. And Webkinz. And Club Penguin.
Pokemon too, right?
And Pokemon.
And Rust is probably my all-time favorite, mainly PvE because I'm a baby.
Elden Ring. How can I forget Elden Ring?
I love Elden Ring.
And Elden Ring.
Elden Ring has pretty much consumed my life. I'm also like really into all the Soul series.
The Grand Theft Auto series. That's what got me first into gaming.
I played a lot of Grand Theft Auto 5.
I like the Grand Theft Auto series as well.
For the past 5 or 6 years, it's really just been multiplayer VR for me.
I love Population 1, Onward, Echo Arena.
What games inspire you?
League of Legends. And it also demoralizes me at the same time, so a little of both. That's it, yeah.
Cool.
All right, we're back. We got the servers. We're on Mar. Leftovers, Limerux, Map 2. Kicking off shortly. Just waiting for players to connect right now.
Absolutely.
Are you excited to see some Mar played today, Rips?
I don't know what day of the week it is, so.
Fair enough. We all struggle with that at times.
Time's a construct. I can't wait to see how the new catwalk plays out. I've only played it a handful of times. Big improvement, I think. It is much, much brighter. I think it looks great.
I absolutely do think that the new catwalk is a general net improvement. It's a little bit easier to work with, and from casting, you can actually go into a lot of the places because, you know, walls are hard as a casting camera.
Well. Yep.
That's right.
I have nets in basketball, but this is it.
All right. Let's unpause. We started the timer a little bit early, so we gave teams a chance to connect.
Yep.
Looks like they are filtering in now. Looks like everybody's going to be playing on the same team here, Rips.
Ooh, yeah, that's a true thinking man's game. If that doesn't resolve itself, then we're going to play chess.
Yeah, this just in. Map 2 is going to be switched to Armory, and teams will be playing chess.
And it's a combination of chess, and then Tidebreaker will be Connect 4.
Connect 4, okay.
Oh, they're figuring it out. They got this.
They're doing it. They're doing stuff and or things. I believe we have to... Absolutely. I think there's a little bit of confusion on what side everybody's supposed to be on, but they're getting it sorted now. Should be going live here in about 2 minutes.
Absolutely. If not, maybe less.
Looks like, I'm not sure, did Ryan play the first match with Limerucks, or is that a substitution? I can't remember.
Ryan, no, that is a, that looks like to be a new person.
Yeah, it looks like Leftovers sticking with their original roster, Sharamesh, Vendetta, Vreezer, Hector, and Pixel Toter. Looks like Sleepy, Sylvath, and Cash still going to be in here.
Playing this a 4-5?
I am not sure right now.
This isn't live. Never mind. Okay, never mind. Disregard. Sorry, I was confused on that one. Okay, they're still waiting on their fifth. One is gonna hop in.
Well, if they don't have their fifth player right away, they'll have to play the first round, a man down, and then they can take a 5-minute tactical timeout if they're having some technical difficulties.
Absolutely.
A little TT. That's right, bud. That's right. I'm fired up, Rips. Are you fired up?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited. I'm here to see how Mars is gonna play. I am excited for some hot zipline action. That's what I'm here for.
Yep.
That's what we're here for.
If anybody does get a one-handed zipline kill, I've been assured that my replays are now working, so we should be able to capture
Absolutely.
That. Absolutely. Let's hope.
Absolutely. No, as a complete guarantee or your money back from Zucchini himself. He says, you're gonna like the way it looks. He guarantees it.
Thanks, Rips. Thanks.
No problem, Zuck. They're still struggling to get their fifth in.
Looks like we are going to probably start this one as a 4-on-5.
Yeah, it's looking like that way because they got 8 seconds or they're going to have to use that tactical timeout like we talked about earlier.
Well, the reality is they can't use it on the first round. They have to play out a round first. So it looks like we are going to be going live here.
Absolutely.
Pistol round, Leftovers, and Limerucks. Map number 2, Mar. Group stage 1, Ivoril playoffs. $35,000 price pool. Let's get it going.
25. I was about to say 100,000. No. Mar is the map number 2, but won my heart.
Leftovers appearing to work towards the B bomb site here.
Absolutely, with some cat work up top.
Yep, got 3 of them in refinery right now. 2 up on cat, 1's on refinery cat here. Just trying to spot anything he possibly can. Hector. Looks like they're going to try and lurk towards the A cat here. Sylvath going to be zipping in, rotating over. Hector hears him. Here's another one on the zip. Here's Cash. Pistols flying around like crazy. Hector going to take down Cash with that silenced USP. Nice. Sylvath, though, going to get flanked. A little bit of pressure from behind, but Hector able to pick
Hector
up 2 there.
Off one-man army.
Ryan taking the lower zip right now. Rotating over to the bomb site. Leftovers full control on B bomb site.
Rating.
Got it planted.
That's a 1v4 situation.
It's right along with Ryan here. Going to drop down to the balcony.
Also, so they found their fifth player.
Fifth player has connected. Ryan looking for whatever they can. Shamrush, though, Ryan, opposite balcony. Takes them down. Clean round from leftovers. 1-0.
That's the wrong score.
Absolutely. 1-0.
Yeah. Okay. I'm doing it right now. All right. Limerux, five people in now. Let's see how they set up. Leftovers seems to be favoring the armory side. Once again, Hector going to go straight up for that mid colonist zip. Get involved. Sleepy and Ryan going to be playing on ACAT here. Probably going to get in a fight with Hector. Hips choosing to take the ladder to get into armory. Interesting play. Four of leftovers heading towards armory. A very strong armory sided push here. Freezer going to take down Hips. Early pick onto the refinery cat there, or the armory cat, sorry. Ryan working their way towards refinery cat, but Freezer also going to take that pick too. A couple of good shots coming out of Freezer.
And Freezer not letting anybody come past, letting people burn below him.
Yeah, but Cash and Sleepy are now behind Freezer. Freezer has to turn around, going to get the trade.
What a play, what a play. Is that a 3K for Breeze? Nice.
Would look like it, yep. Sylvath going to be zipping in. Going to have to fight Shamrush here. In a good position, Shamrush. Taking down Sylvath. Cash, absolutely, all up to him. 1v3.
Show him the money.
Cash knows where he is. Going to try and get involved. Going to get some shots in. Take down Shamrush. Vendetta right there with the refrag. Excellent positioning.
Right behind him. Yep. Absolutely.
Another round in favor of leftovers. Showing that they have come prepared today to play. They're serious. Yes,
they pack their lunches, absolutely.
They got their eyes on Miami. They're ready. But let's not count Limerux out. They've shown that they can come back and present a challenge for leftovers like they did on Keedy.
Absolutely. Yeah, we just watched it happen. It could happen again. It could happen anytime.
Very similar setup again. Hector choosing to go on the ground towards the 8-bomb site here. Freezer up on the zip that Hector normally plays off of. Taking a little bit of cat control. Hips working away up the ladder onto the balcony. The only player on the armory side. Freezer, easy pick. Finds him, not even looking at him.
One of a cat looking to come and try and redeem them. For the rest three are at
Freezer.
A website.
Oh.
Taking them out. A little stutter.
Yeah, quite a bit. We're struggling. Okay, it's fixed itself.
Absolutely.
Leftovers, full control of armory once again. Sleepy going to try and zip into Hellzip there. Two players still left on A. Cash and Sylvath haven't rotated over. Hector's lurking, though. That's a problem. Sleepy's coming back on the zip, trying to hit the zip shot. Hector's going to take them down. 2-on-5 situation.
They got to rotate. They got 35 seconds. They have to take out 5 and defuse. That's going to be a tall order.
Yeah, Cash is way out of position to help Sylvath share. Sylvath's going to end up trying to have to 1v5 this.
Yeah, one-man army, Rambo. And Rambo's down.
Freezer, another pick. Ooh, Cash taking the lower zip. Not ideal.
Struggle bus is real. All right, 1v5, and that's it. That'll be a 0-3.
Rips, what do you think Limerux needs to adjust here in order to get a little bit more map control?
They gotta split a little bit better. They're doing heavily two stack or heavily stacking the wrong site, and they definitely have to split that up a little more. You can play cat, but cat's most important part is definitely for rotates. Looks like they're definitely splitting up a lot more this time. Sending 3 against 4, that's a good play, actually. Wow. Yeah,
Cash, early pick on Hector.
This will play out. Absolutely. This is looking a lot better.
Yeah, this is the right idea. Leftovers clearly favoring the armory side. Limerick's making the appropriate adjustments to put a couple more people there to help provide some support. Although they're zipping away now, going over towards A. They've left only one player, and that's Sylvath. Hiding up here in the back stairs. This is a really good spot in armory. Really good spot. Vendetta working their way around, though. Finds Sylvath on the back, and a nade was coming. That was tough.
2 seconds.
All of Limerux is over on A again.
I looked at it for 2 seconds. Yeah, they're down. Yeah, it's a 3-4. They're going to try and push. They should push as a team. There you go. They're getting together. They're working it out.
They definitely are. Limerick's full cat control here. Vreezer's going to be waiting, though. Get involved with one on Armory Cat there. Ryan picking up the refrag, though.
Absolutely.
Still a 2-on-3. Still a 2-on-3 situation. 10 seconds left on the scanner. I just don't think there's enough time here.
Is not. Yeah, he's going to get... Yeah, he had a person on each side. That was a strong defense from Shamrish and Pixel. That was rough to walk into. Loss.
Cash looking like get the hands up there, surrendering.
the hands up, don't shoot.
I think Limerux is favoring a little bit.
They had the right idea.
They set up well in the beginning of the round, but then they rotated off as soon as Hector got picked. I'm not sure they suspected a heavy A push there, but looks like again they're setting up for heavy A. And Leftovers is going towards Armory.
Going full Armory. I mean, we'll see how it plays out. Cash looking to be playing maybe at least a little bit more in the mid.
Breezer's going to spot that, but Hector. That
one. They should definitely do that rotate. Should be on. There it is. There it is.
Yep.
A lot faster than last time. I like to see it. I'm taking that convenient zip line.
Scan started.
Bomb is planted. Shamrash, same spot every time. Wicked spot. Very strong. 2-on-3.
Absolutely.
Sleepy gonna be working their way into Refinery, trying to come up behind here. Gonna have to deal with Pixel. Oh, there's a cross angle. That's tough. Gets the smoke out there. Really smart. Takes down Pixel.
Ooh, but Hips unable to take down the two people that were watching that angle. We'll see if Sleepy can take the one and maybe the other.
Pros don't fake. Sleepy just sticking it one-handed with the gun, but Vendetta's going to get involved.
I don't know where that saying came from. I fake all the time. It was a good try, though. Good try. 0-5. Leftovers. In the lead.
Starting. I keep forgetting to update the score on the deck. We're going to quickly do that because it's my first day.
Don't know what that means.
It's fine, Rips. You just keep doing you.
Absolutely. I guarantee it.
Leftovers really not changing anything. I guess if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Absolutely. Same setup.
Another hard Armory push.
Yep, they've got three going into Refinery. Vreezer up top on the cat and Hector down low. Vreezer's going to pick up Hips. Ryan's really extending.
Yeah. Ryan could.
Oh, he's unable to hit Hector. Yeah. That's too bad. Hector great spins
shot,
around.
Great
shot, yeah, nice shot by Hector. That leaves it all up to a 2-on-5 situation.
Yep.
Both players. I got stuck on the wall there, so that was a bad angle. A
scanner. Last one left. And, unfortunate. Unlucky.
Six oh, Leftovers really running away with this one right now. Limerux has to absolutely change it up and find a way to get some momentum, claw back into this game. And Leftovers doing the same play again. Looks like three towards Refinery, one up on the cat, one down low. Big stack coming out of Limerux.
There's that full stack. That's what we're looking for. They're gonna be hit with this one. Oh. Vreezer picking up Sleepy.
Ryan and Cash trying to find that refrag. They don't know where that was from. Vreezer, though. Absolutely. Oh, look at the positioning.
Oh, no. He's going to go for the three.
Oh, Vreezer, insane.
Absolutely.
Round loss.
Let's test out the instant replay functionality. It looks like it is actually working. Huge 3K.
Definitely broken. I'm just kidding. I have no idea.
No, it actually is working now, Rips.
Nice.
That's another round in favor of Leftovers.
Absolutely, but that was a lot better of a play, though. They had a lot better of a chance of taking that round. They are definitely heavily stacking that site appropriately now.
And Leftovers, just they have limited to no fear. They're doing the exact same play again. It's working for them.
Absolutely.
Limerux getting involved. All Limerick's four outside.
Yeah. Ooh, that's a bold
Vreezer,
move. Getting
Hector.
Two. Yep.
3-on-5. Ooh, Ryan going to pick up.
Taking the flank, yeah.
Breezer's just going nuts. This guy's a Mar player.
Absolutely.
Round loss.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Ooh,
hate to see it.
Lava? Yeah,
I think I think they fell.
Ooh. That's why you know, don't fall off of
Freezer. Freezer is absolutely running away with this one right now. 18-3. What a performance out of Freezer.
Absolutely. All right, they're same play.
Same play. Ryan and Sleepy.
One back.
Ryan and Sleepy gonna elect to use the back zip.
Look at this. Look at this.
Yeah, I see it.
Behind him.
Oh, but Cash gonna find him.
Taking out the flank. That was good. That was good. Ryan picking up Breeze. That's big.
Vendetta entry into sight now. They have a little bit of control in Armory.
Absolutely. This is looking really good.
Sleepy's right there though. He knows the bomb's getting planted. Ooh. Oh, Shamresh.
Picked up from the side on the stairs. Absolutely.
Shamresh in the same spot every time. Absolutely. Too strong.
3v3.
Cash can try and zip in. Limerick's really taking this uncoordinated. One player coming in while the other players are still rotating, and Shamresh gonna pick him up again from the same position. That stairs position is really strong, as we're seeing. Now they've got the cross. Yeah,
no, stairs are, they go up and down.
Hip's gonna take down Shamresh though. Good call out to find that player, but Pix on the other side gonna pick up Hip's. 10 seconds left on Ryan. The scanner.
Ooh, good try though. That was a lot closer.
That was a lot closer, and
they looked at the flank though. That was
That's it. And Limerick did a really good job of retaking that. They were a little bit off timing, but the post plant setup there was awesome from leftovers. Yeah. They were ready for it. Looks like they're gonna play the exact same colonist setup.
And there is only B. A doesn't exist.
A does not exist. Limerick's gonna go for John 4. Lee's
strategy.
Hector up on the zip now.
Manor.
Sylvath and Ryan trying to push through on the lower. See if they can pick something up. Hector going to find Sylvath from the top stairs. Yeah. Ryan trying to find Freezer, but can't locate.
Yeah. Oh, he found him, but it was a little bit too late.
And that's going to be a 3-on-5. But all players, all members of Limerick's currently...
They could get the scanner down.
Huge 2K from Cash to even it up into a 3-on-3.
Absolutely.
Cash going to pick up another one. Big 3K now.
That's a 3K.
Oh, with the tactical reload. Using the AK mag to hit the other AK mag out. We love to see it.
Absolutely. Sleepy taking the long zip. That's my favorite zip.
Neither player on leftovers has the scanner right now, so it's clearly been dropped somewhere, but Hector's going to be flanking around the spawn side and pick up Sleepy after taking the long zip. 2-on-2.
Uh-oh, 2-1.
Rip's going to find Freezer. Oh, Cash picks up Freezer, but Hector's right there for the refrag. So close to an ace. So close to an ace.
Yep, and there's the side swap.
I'm pressing the buttons. I'm pressing the buttons.
The team confirmed is pressing buttons.
What a half from leftovers. What a half. 10-0. An excellent performance.
Is this the time for the comeback?
I believe. Limerox isn't out yet.
Full faith.
Looks like they're going to be sending three towards A. One's going to be working outside. Going to try and get involved with Hector here. Hector's getting a little bit aggressive and challenging Cash here. Neither player able to find each other.
Going into A because I got two in there.
Shamresh going to take down Sylvath there outside of Armory. Ryan going to be going through hole in the wall. Breeze are going to find Cash. Ryan going to get denied any entrance into a hole in the wall, and it's going to leave it up to a 2-on-5 situation. Hips has back cat control right now. Sleepy going to zip into Armory here, but three leftover players on Armory. He's going to drop right in front of Vendetta and get taken down. This is it. It's all up to Hips. This is it. If Hips does not win this round, leftovers will be moving on. And that's it. Hector finds it.
Good try. Absolutely.
And that's all she wrote for this match, folks. Leftovers.
Absolutely.
Going to be moving on to round number 2. Well played by everybody. Quick score recap. Breezer absolutely running away on that game. Just so good outside. So much control.
Absolutely. He worked cat very, very well that whole time. That was very impressive.
He absolutely did. All right. Let's switch over to the analyst desk. What'd you think of that match, Rips?
Oh, that was a hell of a match. That was... I want to see a little bit more on that defense from Limerick's, but they got it together towards the end there, but I think it was too little too late. They definitely had the right idea towards the end there.
Yeah. Yeah, they did make some late adjustments, and they, you know, almost worked out for them.
It worked a lot better, yeah.
Yeah, they were right there. I mean, credit to Leftovers. They really didn't care what adjustments were made. They still ran through. They ran the same setup. They clearly have practiced that
every time.
Yeah,
very impressive.
They went with the same setup every time. I've never seen a team do that, but, you know, credit where credit is due. That's a 10-0 half. You can't fault them for that, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, no, if it's not broken, especially to that extent, keep sending it.
Clearly, absolutely. I need to add that one to my playbook. 3 to Refinery, 1 on the Cat, 1 lower control.
And, well, I hate to put this out there. That's actually a treat. That's one of my plays, so just joking.
All right.
But yeah, no, I can't wait to see where they go from there. It was good, though. I was hoping for that comeback. That's what I really wanted to see.
Yeah, I had belief. I mean, Limerick's went down a lot in Keedy, but they were able to get some rounds on the board and make a match out of it. Unfortunately, weren't able to get through Pistol on Colonist, and that was all she wrote there. But it was a really nice try nonetheless. They played well.
Absolutely.
You know, it's good just to see everybody out here competing and having fun and playing this, and it's an exciting time for VR esports, and we're happy to be here in casting. It's our first day. Absolutely. Don't judge. I mean, Rips looks very professional with the Pit Vipers, so...
Yep, Pit Viper sunglasses. These are actually knockoffs. But yeah, no, and all the zip lines. I'm excited to see Mar played today. That is probably one of my favorite maps, especially because of zip lines. Zip lines are best lines.
The zip lines are just plain fun.
Absolutely. Yeah, 100%.
And I honestly think that map's come a long way, and it's a fun and competitively viable map. I know people have opinions on it, but I think it's fun and exciting to play. Personally,
absolutely, yes, yeah. It went from how do we rotate to this is probably one of my favorite map. Actually, I think it is my favorite map at this point.
Yeah, I mean, I personally prefer it over Keedy, but I have a soft spot for Suna given the previous game experience I have. But yeah, no, it's exciting to see it played. Same with Keedy, right? We've been playing Suna up until this point.
Yeah.
It's nice to see some other maps and some other strategies. And anyways, we're going to cut to a quick intermission here. We'll find another match to get casted, whether it's round two or picking up a late match in round one. We'll see what we can do. Don't go anywhere, folks.